Okay, so today I'm going to show you guys how to straighten hair. As no-brainer as that may be to some of you, I guess some people don't know how to straighten hair, so I'm just going to show you how. Now, the way that I straighten my hair now is not the way that I used to always straighten my hair. So I used to kind of just run the flat iron through it, like in chunks, and wonder why I still had kinks in my hair, and I just always looked a little weird. So this is my hair when I wake up in the morning. Honestly, my hair is naturally straight ever since I started dyeing it. It's kind of gotten wavy, kind of like this, but it's not like a pretty wavy, it's kind of just nasty. I guess that's what you get. I don't know if it's wavy like this or if it's because I sleep on it wet. I don't think you're supposed to sleep with wet hair, but I don't really care. I take a shower at night, so I don't take a shower in the morning. I take a shower before I go to bed, and I don't blow dry it because, I don't know, usually I shouldn't be running the blow dryer late at night because I take showers late at night and everyone's usually asleep by then, and people aren't too happy that the blow dryer is running in the other room. So I just kind of I just towel dry my hair and then air dry it for about 15 minutes and then I go to bed. So this is what I always wake up with. Sometimes it's straighter than this, sometimes it's not, but yeah. So I have it up in a clip right now. So let me just show you all the nappiness when my hair is down. So it's kind of poofy, it's kind of wavy. So let me just get started. First thing I'm gonna do is brush through this. And when I brush through this, it's not pretty. It actually gets poofier and just a hot mess. So yeah, just gonna brush. Okay, so once I have it brushed where I can actually run my fingers through it, for the most part anyways, I have a lot of hair, like a lot of hair. It's fine and thick hair combination kind of going on in there, but a lot of it. Okay. So when I curl my hair or straighten my hair, I have to do it in sections. Usually I have to do it in three sections, but for the sake of this tutorial, I'm going to do it in two sections, which is not recommended if you have as much hair as I do. Okay, so the whole part of my hair doesn't really matter at this point, because it kind of just naturally falls to wherever the part is. It's just, it may not be like completely straight. And then with my thumbs, I just part down what I think is the middle. Kind of like you're doing a half up, half down hair. And then I kind of just twist it into a bun on the top of my head just so it's out of the way. And all I have is this big gigantic clip, so that's what I'm going to use to secure it like that. Then I'm left with the bottom half. Okay, so the straightener that I've been using is just this purple one from Remington. I got this from Target for, I know it was under 20 bucks. It was either around the $15 range or less. It's a 1 inch. So while that's heating up, it says it takes 30 seconds to heat up, but I find that it takes a lot longer because when it stops blinking is when it's supposed to have hit the temperature right there, and it hasn't stopped blinking yet. And then I know it's been more than 30 seconds, so I just brush out the sections again. And then with my favorite heat spray, always use a heat spray if you're flat ironing or blow drying your hair. I'm using Tresemme's Thermal Creations Heat Tamer Spray. I'm sure you all seen this before. Other people use it. This is my favorite. It's the cheapest also. I don't know, there's something wrong with my nozzle. So it doesn't really spray, it kind of spews everywhere. So I gotta be careful when I spray this. Do you see how it sprays? It's so terrible. I need to get a new one, but I've been lazy. Anyways,
it's literally like I'm soaked in this stuff. I don't even know if it's hitting my hair. I'm hoping it is.
Why, nozzle? Why?
Do you see? This is how it comes out. But whatever. I'm just gonna brush it through anyways.
Okay. And once you have your hair heat protected, okay, it stopped blinking. So then I kind of just grab sections. So it can be anywhere between 1 to 2 inch sections. The thinner, the better, the straighter your hair will get, I find. At least with this flat iron, that's the case. I don't really need to start all the way at the root because it doesn't really get, like, doesn't really curl at the roots anyways. It's pretty straight there. So I just run it through the piece 1 to 2 times. Usually one will do it, but sometimes I need to do it twice. Kind of just depends also on how thick the section is. And then do it again. Don't have to do it, you don't have to run it through too slowly, but not too fast either, or else it won't get a chance to flatten it. Usually my second pass through, I go quicker than the first time. I don't know. Don't know if that's beneficial to my hair or not, but that's just how I do it. And I just always throw it back once I'm done with it. So forward when it's not done, throw it back once you finish straightening. Okay, then you just have a bunch of straight hair. Look at how thinner it looks once I straighten it compared to earlier. Okay. I'm gonna split this top half and bring it to the front. Oy, so much hair. Okay, looks like I'm gonna have to do this into threes, so. Again, part this half into another half, and we're gonna clip this top half just like that. Oh, that's cute. Okay, and then brush through this section. So as you reach like the top layers, it is more important that you're kind of not being so lazy with it, because obviously these are the more visible strands of hair. Any waves or kinks in it are going to be highly, highly visible to the world, and the world is an ugly place, and the world also has some really ugly people that like to point out little tiny things like that. So to avoid it, just avoid the kinks and the waves, and then they can't say nothing. Oh, and be careful, like if you have really dark hair. I remember when I used to have like brunette hair, right after I'd pass through it, I'd like go run my fingers through it. Oh my god, don't do that, it burns. Like, your hair is hot. I'm sure that's common sense to some, but to me, it was not until I burned my finger with my own hair. And then last section.
God. This last section is usually like the frizziest, like gross looking. Okay, so we're gonna grab it from the back. We're gonna brush it through. How gross that looks. I usually need a few passes on this top section. Brush it through. Okay, and if you find that your hair is like dry and brittle after straightening it, you may want to invest in like a silk therapy or just, I don't know, like a hair oil. This is BioSilk Silk Therapy. So this is for your hair and your skin. Like if you have like dry hands, you could use it on your hands, elbows and stuff. But it's amazing for your hair. BioSilk Silk Therapy. This is the 11.6 fluid ounce bottle. You can get them like in bottles that big from Walgreens and CVS. But you can get like larger ones like this from the salon. Depending on how much hair you have, I don't even know if you could see that. You only need a little tiny, tiny bit like that. You rub it through your hands. It's totally clear, so I don't know why I'm showing you. And then you kind of just run it through wet or dry hair. And then just brush it through. This video was really long just because I was explaining everything that I was doing, but normally it should only take me like 15 minutes to do, 10-15 minutes to do all this in the morning. I don't do this every morning anyways. It just depends on how wavy and gross my hair looks when I wake up. And that is how you straighten your hair. So I hope that was helpful, and yeah. Thank you all so much for watching and subscribing if you have. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.